Today I'm showing you how I created this vector portrait in Adobe Illustrator. So let's get going. So the lovely lady I am drawing today is Talia, and what we're going to do is take the pen tool and outline all the prominent features on her face. So I have the pen tool, like I said, and I'm clicking and dragging to adjust the curve level of the blue lines. If you've not used the pen tool before, it will take a bit of trial and error, but I can definitely make a tutorial on how to get the hang of it. If you'd like to see that, let me know. But the kind of principle of this whole video is to outline the areas of importance on the face. So I'm filling in the eyebrows, and then outlining everything, as you can see. Then onto the eyes. Firstly, I always do the upper lash line. So I'll do one line curved, and then I'll change the stroke on it. So you'll see that the line I've just drawn is just a solid black line, which is the same width all the way through. But up here, I'm going to change it to this kind of wonky shaped one. Change the width of it and you'll see that it's created more of a kind of brushstroke effect, I guess, so you can see more of a realistic shape for the lash line. Then I'm going to repeat that for the lower lash line, and I use this tool quite a lot throughout the video. You'll see that I'll do some strokes and then change the kind of look of that stroke and how like the shape fits, if that makes any sense whatsoever. So now I'm just doing the kind of block colours. I've done the whites of her eyes and sent it to the back of the file, just using the layers panel and dragging it to the back, or using the shortcut on screen. And then I'm going to do the centre of the eye and the colour of the eye. I never know what these are called. It's very obvious English terminology, but I always forget. But basically, I've drawn two circles and I've selected a colour from the original image to fill that vector shape. So I'm just lining them up, and then I also add a stroke colour, so an outline colour if you want to call it that, on the outside, because generally eyes have kind of two-toned colours in them. Now I'm taking the erase tool and I'm just erasing the bits that overlap the upper lash line and then changing the arrangement of the shapes. So using the same tool we used before, I'm just going to send it to the back. So you can either right click and send to back or just use the shortcut on the screen. And then as you can see, it's now behind that upper lash line. I'm going to erase anything that overlaps. There's probably an easier way of doing this, but I've just always done it this way. Now I'm going to draw a line for kind of the crease in the eye. So this is just a solid line with no join on it. And then again, I'm using that uniform tool at the top, changing the width, and you can see it's more of a fluid, natural looking line. I use the same principle actually for the eyelashes. So as this picture isn't the clearest, I kind of guessed where the eyelashes were. So I adjusted them twice, then I select them all, change the look of the stroke as usual, and then change the width, and you can see that they kind of taper, so they're thicker at one end and thinner at the other, and that's how I get my eyelash effect. Do the same on the top and bottom lashes, and then you'll see that I kind of adjust the colours to fit. I'll do the bottom lash line again because it didn't look right, and it's just a lot of trial and error and adjusting. And generally, once I've done one eye, I get to cheat and I will copy and paste it over to the other eye and kind of flip it so it's a complete mirror image. So to do that, I've just pressed the Alt key on my keyboard, dragged it across and then flipped it over. Again, you can right click, transform and rotate or reflect, but I like to do it this way. It was just a bit quicker this time. And then I'm just arranging them because obviously this eye isn't exactly the same shape as the other one just because of the angle. So I'm arranging them to fit my second eyeball. I do have such a weird way of explaining things sometimes. I really hope you guys are following this. If you aren't, I have written a blog post on it which has a little bit more in-depth explanations about the various different gestures and commands that I use. So now I am outlining the darker areas of the face. So generally I like to work from the shadows, so I go to the dark parts. So I've done the nostrils, the kind of nose creases, and then I'm going on to the lips and just doing the same process. Like I said at the beginning, it's effectively just outlining every main part of the face and joining it all together and colouring it in the right colour. So now for the hair is kind of, it's the bit I always kind of hate doing because it's very easy to get wrong. And I actually did this drawing twice because the first time I did the hair, it looked very weird. So this time you'll see that I'm not exactly following the shape of the hair in the original image. I've made it up. So it does just depend on what your photo looks like, but don't be afraid to kind of go outside the lines. So I've done that, I'm filling in that shape as one solid colour, and then I'm just going to go back and do the face, the other side of the hair, and you'll see on the right hand side that I've now opened the layers panel. So this is all the different elements in this image, and you'll see that I turn on and off different layers. I'll move them up and down so they're kind of arranged in the right way. If you've used Photoshop, it's basically the same principle as Photoshop. Once I've got the basic kind of block colours in there, I'm gonna go in and do the finer details. So I'm going to do the teeth. The teeth are usually quite difficult to do, but just with a little bit of adjustment and moving, if you zoom out, look at it as a whole picture, adjust it, go back in, you know, trial and error, see how it looks. And you'll see that I change these quite a lot. And they were frustrating me, but we got there. And then I'm just going to use the brush tool to fill it in with a darker colour. And then what I'm going to do now is what I think is the most important and most effective part of a vector drawing, and that is the shadows. So right now the image looks quite flat, but once I add these shadows, it gives it a bit of dimension. You'll be able to see kind of the shape of her face a little better. And basically I'm just doing the same principle. I'm tracing the shadows that are on the original image and then moving them in the layer panel down to the correct area, and there you have it. So yeah, again, trial and error, and it's not the most simple thing to do. It definitely took me a lot of time and practice, but after a while I figured out the best way for me. So definitely get practicing if you want to try it. You'll see that I'm adding the kind of tear duct areas. This bit was annoying me. I don't know why I got kind of stuck doing this, and there were some bits of it that I'd missed. So I'm going back through, kind of adjusting them, moving the little squares. Well, I mean, anchor points, not squares. And then kind of adding shadows as and when I see them. Again, I will click on and off between the original image and the vector image just to make sure I'm on track. As you can see, I kind of trace around the original image and then turn that one off and check it against the digital version. So you can see that I'm going around the shadows of the nose, kind of guessing where the darkest bits are if I can't see them, and then adjusting the skin tone layer and kind of inserting it in the right place. So once I've got the basic shadows down, I like to do some highlights. So I always, always do some kind of eye highlight. It's super important. It makes your character look alive. Then I'll do a cheekbone highlight, a nose highlight. Sometimes I'll do under the eyebrows, and usually on the lips. You'll see, especially on the lips, how much of a difference it makes just giving it a few different colours. So the lips are made out of three different shades of the same kind of nudie pink colour, but just adding those extra shades made such a difference and kind of made the lips pop. Then I decided to add this little smile line bit. I also decided to add this circle in the background. I thought it framed it quite well, so I'm just using the circle tool, and I coloured it kind of a blush pink shade, sent it to the back, and then filled in the extra parts of her body that I missed. When I first started drawing this, I wasn't sure how much of her body I would be keeping and showing on the final image, so I just went back and filled in those bits and kind of made it fit in the circle, I guess. So now I'm on to my least favourite part, it's doing the hair. I find that doing curly hair is always the most difficult, so as I have for the rest of this tutorial, I'm just outlining the darker bits of her hair. So everything that I can see that's a little bit of a darker brown, I'm going to highlight that and then highlight that, well, darken that. And then for the highlights, I'm also adding some lines and colouring them a lighter colour. So you'll see that the hair is made up of three different colours, like a mid-tone colour, a dark colour and a light colour, and that's the principle I like to go off for my portraits in general. And then I'll also change the opacities of each stroke, so you'll see that these have different shapes, and then I'll change the opacity so they're a little bit lighter. So now onto the final touches. I mean, this kind of speaks for itself, but this is what kind of added more personality, and I absolutely love how this turned out in the end. I added a little bit of shadow behind her on the circle area, and I also made her hair and her top of her head kind of overlay the outline of the circle, and I absolutely love it. So yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. I know it was super speedy and quick, but I can do a more in-depth tutorial if you would like to see that, just let me know. As always, I'm not an expert, but thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you soon for another video. Bye!